Thank you for your introduction and applause. So let's start my talk. Can you see my screen? The title is Join PyCon JP as a staff with Python. Thank you. And I talk in this talk about automation, about Slack and Google Drive using AWS. So let's start this talk. So nice to meet you, everyone. Please call me Nikki, and I'm joining from Japan. Thank you for the opportunity to speak remotely in PyCon Taiwan. And sorry, my audio setting is a little strange, so I can hear another speaker voice, so please check myself the audio setting. Sorry. Okay, maybe I hear another session voice from Discord channel for remote speaker. So I muted the Discord and go ahead on this talk. So last year, actually, I gave a lightning talk at PyCon Taiwan. And the lightning talk about PyCon JP staff activities. And this time, I'm very happy to talk to you. Let me introduce myself. I use the ID FTNext on Twitter and GitHub. I'm working on natural language processing at Userbase in Tokyo. I'm so lazy that I'm enthusiastic about automating boring stuff with Python. I've been staff of PyCon JP since last year. In this summer, I've been speaking online at PyCons around the world. I talked about this topic at PyCon Africa in August, and I speak on another topic, bring your Python script to more users at EuroPython. And I hold a workshop at PyCon APAC next week. So if you're interested in, please join the workshop. So let's cut the chase. This talk is a case study about automation with Python. I will share some examples of automation in PyCon JP staff activities. Do you know PyCon JP? In 2020, PyCon JP was held as an online conference last week. Conference is 2 days, and we have 50 over talks and 550 over participants. If you want to know PyCon JP history, please check Takanori-san's talk. Okay, I precede this talk. And PyCon JP is big, and there's a lot to do. In the staff activities, we use a lot of services. For example, we communicate in Slack and collaborate in G Suite. When I use Slack and G Suite in staff activities, I found that some points were not cool with the tool. I was going through a series of boring operations over and over again. I wanted to handle the stuff better, so automated the recurring boring stuff with Python. I'll tell you the details later. In 2020, I have many tasks as a leader of the program team. I want to focus my resources on tasks that humans need to do. In other words, the tasks machines cannot do. For example, I want to focus on proposal design and speaker communications. By automation, I let the machine do the recurring boring stuff for me. Automation brings the saving the labor and stable quality of output. Using Python, I can do more things as well. I might be 10 times PyCon staff in the future. The table of contents are here. I introduce two examples. And referring to my proposal, you can take away five things. I handle automate the stuff about Slack or Google Drive with Python. And I talk about Amazon Web Services, aka AWS. The first example is a customized Slack reminder. From this example, you can take away two things. One, how to post a message to Slack with Python, and two, how to do this regularly using AWS Lambda. PyCon JP staff communicate with each other in Slack. For example, to set up a meeting, I ask the staff what days they are available. There are so many posts on PyCon JP Slack that posts flow away after a few days. You need to post the message repeatedly to make sure others see the post and do the action. It is tedious to post repeatedly by hand. Slack supports the reminder feature, so let's use it. Type slash remind, then specify a channel and what and when. In this example, Slack bot reminds us of the message every noon. Automate the repeat post with Slackbot using slash remind. But there is a thing that I felt was not cool. Slackbot posts every day after the meeting. So we have to stop the reminder manually and remember when to stop. It's turn of the customized Slack reminder. I created a reminder which can end automatically. There is no need to stop manually or remember when to stop. The customized reminder consists of three components. One, Python script. Two, Google Spreadsheets. And three, AWS Lambda. This is an image of a Google Spreadsheet. Each row represents to post a message, including text and URL in channel from start date to end date. This example shows from 27th May to 4th June post in the 2020 channel. The Python script does three things. One, fetch data in the spreadsheet. And two, determine if the message needs to be posted. Then three, post message to Slack. First, we take a look at how to post a message to Slack with Python. To post to Slack with Python, create a Slack app, then configure and install it. Jot down both user or host token. To post a message to Slack, call the endpoint chat post message with the post method. When in Roma, do as the Romans do. So when calling the Slack APIs, do as the documents read. Request header contains two items, authorization and content type. In the authorization field, use the bot user token. The request body is JSON encoded. Specify the channel and text for chat.postMessage endpoint. In implementation, we use urlib from the Python standard library. In implementation, create a header as seen in the documentation, like this one, authorization and content type, and you use the Slack token in authorization value. Prepare JSON encoded body using JSON dumps. Using the header and the body, send a post request to the Slack API using urlib. Next, Let's see how to fetch data in Google Spreadsheets with Python. Python operates Spreadsheets via Sheets API. We use the GSpread package, a wrapper of Sheets API version 4. To operate the spreadsheet with Python, in Google Cloud Platform Console, enable Sheets API, then create a service account. Share the target spreadsheet with the service account. We are ready to go. Create a client from the service account, like Discord, and using the client, access the target spreadsheet and the first worksheet. Then get all values the worksheet as a list of lists. Lastly, I tell the logic to determine if the message needs to be posted. Do you remember? Each row in the spreadsheet has a start date and end date. If the execution date is between the start date and the end date, like this diagram, the message of the row needs to be posted to Slack. If the execution date is before the start date or after the end date, the message does not need to be posted. That's all for Python script. I've told you about the implementation and data. Now we want to run the script periodically, right? In this time, I chose AWS for periodically execution. I will tell you about AWS Lambda. According to AWS Developer Guide, AWS Lambda is a compute service that lets you run code without provisioning or managing servers. All we have to prepare is only code, so it is called serverless, which means no need for us to manage servers. We can deploy a module in Python script as a Lambda function. AWS Lambda supports a wide range of programming languages. We need to specify runtime. After creating a Lambda function in AWS console, you can edit Python code on your browser. This editor is handy because it enables us to try and error. In the default setting, the Lambda handler function is executed, so put your code in the function. Put the code I've prepared so far in the Lambda handler function. The GSpread package is not installed in the Lambda function runtime. I will tell you how to install a third-party package later. And I set the contents of service account to the environment variable. I will explain it in the appendix. Lambda functions are event-driven. When an event occurs, it executes a configured Lambda function. We want to run the Lambda function periodically, like once a day, so we occur the event once a day. To occur events periodically, we use CloudWatch events. CloudWatch event schedules the occurrence of an event, specified in a format similar to colon expressions. CloudWatch events route events to the Lambda function with a specified rule. In your browser, add CloudWatch event as a trigger. This Lambda function runs once a day. Now we need to install the GSpread package in the Lambda function runtime. I recommend using Lambda layers. To create a Lambda layer, zip the package on your command line and upload it from your browser. Install the packages in the target directory with pip install t option, then zip the directory and upload the zip file. Add the GSpread layer to the function so it can import now. There is a pitfall in creating the zip file. Python packages vary by platform, so installed packages in macOS may not work well in the Lambda runtime, Amazon Linux environment. One solution is to run Amazon Linux on the development PC. I run the Amazon Linux Docker image and install the packages in the container. It is recap time. To post a message to Slack, use urlib as the Slack document's read. And to post a message regularly on AWS, create Lambda function and OKA events with CloudWatch events. And this item is update from PyCon Africa. So if you interested this information, please check the slide and my GitHub repository. And this is short break, but I must end this talk in 10 minutes or less, so I go ahead. The second example is the Slack command to copy template Google Documents. From this example, you can take away two things. One, how to manipulate Google Drive documents with Python. And two, a series of ways to manipulate Google Drive documents from Slack. PyCon JP staff hold meeting every other week. We take minutes of meeting in Google Documents. Before the meeting, we copy a template document manually. There is a thing that I felt was not cool. I don't want to copy a template manually every other week. I started to write a Python script for automation. The Python script does one thing, copy the file in Google Drive. To copy, we specify the target file ID, this part in the URL, and it's same for spreadsheets and slides. Python operates files in Google Drive via Drive API. And you may heard PyDrive package. It is known as a wrapper of Drive API version 2. In this time, we use PyDrive 2, the actively maintained fork of PyDrive. Before calling Drive API with Python, visit the Google Cloud Platform console and enable Drive API, then create an OAuth client ID and download it. This is the implementation of the authentication part. You can write the configuration in the settings YAML, and settings YAML is here. This means using OAuth client library, client ID file in the same directory, and it saved credential file exists, and refresh automatically, then authenticate, like this setting. The first time you run the script, your browser will launch. You need to select your account. If authentication passed, credentials are saved in your PC. After the second time, your browser won't launch because the script uses the saved credentials. After authentication, you can copy the file by specifying the ID in file ID parameter. I've packaged the script for my use case. This code calls OAuth code and copy code we just saw. Run the entry point script with the file ID. It copies the specified file in the same folder. I did it. Got a script to automate the boring stuff. But in staff activities, I often use a web browser. Can I run the script from the browser? To run the scripts from browser, I converted the script to a Lambda function, then set up to call the Lambda function from Slack. You know how to make a Lambda function from the first example. In this time, I created Lambda layer from my writing package, then arrange the script and credentials as in the local PC. A Lambda function code is here. And let's see how to call this Lambda function from Slack. We use something called slash command. Here's the slash command I made. Call the command slash cp in drive and file ID. When the command is executed, the link of the copied file will be displayed. Actually, slash remind is a built-in slash command. Slash command consists of two things, the Slack app and the request URL. We've already made the Slack app in the custom reminder section. Slash command needs additional settings written, so please visit the appendix. After a user invokes, slash command sends the data to the request URL. Now we want Slack to send the data to Lambda function. To attach URL to the Lambda function, we use Amazon API Gateway. It allows us to create an API endpoint, so we have Slack to send it to the endpoint. According to the Slack document, when a user invokes the slash command, Slack sends the post request as form URL encoded. Configure the API gateway to match Slack's behavior. Create an API for the post method, and using mapping templates, enable the endpoint to process form URL encoded data, and then attach the URL to the file copy function. You need to add some code in the Lambda function. To verify the request from Slack, write Python code as the document read. Maybe this explanation is too short, but if the request is within 5 minutes and the hash of the data matches, it passes verification and runs the copy code. Using parseQS method from URL read, pass the sent data from Slack. The field text includes the target file ID. Actually, it still takes more ingenuity, but I can't tell you in the time left, so check out appendix. It is recap time. To manipulate Google Drive documents, prepare OAuth client ID and use PyDrive 2. And to run the command to manipulate Google Drive files from Slack, set up slash command, create an endpoint with API gateway, attach it to the Lambda function, and specify it as the request URL of slash command. Here's a recap of our case study. I shared two examples. One is a customized Slack reminder, which shows how to run Python script periodically in AWS. And the other is Slack command to copy template Google Docs, which shows how to run Python script on AWS from Slack via URL. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Nikki. Very interesting sharing. So, any question? No? Any questions here? No, let's see if there are any questions in Slido. No? Any questions in YouTube? Okay, so I have a question. So you know, if I come to Taiwan, we use Discord this year. So would you consider to switch to Discord in your event next year?
Oh, switch Discord? In this talk, I talk about automation in Slack, and I can migrate the source code to Slack to Discord. I want to try the automation, but. In staff activities, we use Discord is under consideration. So, but Discord is useful. Talk about Discord and maybe we use Discord for PyCon JP 2021.
Okay, thank you. So if you have any further question, please move to Discord channel and Nikki will answer your question later. So thanks Nikki again. Thank you.
Thank you very much.